In this video, we are going to discuss six string methods. Is alpha numeric? Is alnum? Is alpha? Is decimal? Is digit? Is identifier? And is numeric? Is alnum returns true if all characters in the string are alphanumeric? Is alpha returns true if all characters in the string are alphabets? Is decimal, is digit, and is numeric? All three will give same result, returns true if all characters in the string are decimals or digits or numeric values. And is identifier returns true if the string is an identifier. We will try to understand the meaning of these functions with the help of examples. Look at first example. I am using three strings, S1, which has all the alphabets, A to M. Second string, S2, which has all the digits, all the decimal values, numeric values. And I am using third string, S3, which is a mix of alphabets and digits, alphanumeric, I can say. So I am trying to use alnum, is alnum, is alpha, is decimal, is digit, and is numeric, all these five functions to check which string is alphanumeric, which string is having only alphabets, and which string is having only digits. So s1.isAlnum will check whether s1 is alphanumeric, whether s2 is alphanumeric, whether s3 is alphanumeric. So if you look at s1, s2, s3, s1 is alphanumeric, it contains alphabets and digits, yes. S2, alphabets and digits, yes, because every character is alphabet or as well as digit. S3, is it alphanumeric? No, because it contains white space. Second print statement, I am using is alpha function. I am checking whether S1 contains only alphabets. Yes, so answer is true. S2, is it containing only alphabets? No, answer is false. S3, is it containing only alphabets? No, it contains white space and digits, so false. Third print statement, is decimal. S1, is it only containing decimal values? No, false. S2, is it containing only decimal values? Yes, true. S3, is it containing only decimal values? No, it is alphanumeric. Next function, is digit. Now, if you look at decimal, digit, and numeric, is decimal, is digit, is numeric, the output is same because all three functions checks the same thing. Okay, so answer is same, false, true, false. So this is how you can use is alnum, is alpha, is decimal, is digit, and is numeric. Generally, these functions are used when you want to check whether my string only contains alphabets, only contains digits, only contains any specific characters. So in that case, you can use these functions. Now we will see how we can use is identifier. Now, what is the meaning of identifier? Identifier is a valid string. When I say identifier, it means valid string. So whenever we give any variable a name, whatever rules we implement for defining a variable, the same rules are used for identifier. For example, if I look at S1, the value of S1 is QWERT. It is a valid string, no problem. If I look at S2, S2 contains all the digits. Can I have a variable with this name? This is a value. We cannot have a variable with this name. This cannot be a valid variable name. The QWERT can be a valid variable name, but this cannot be a valid variable name. Can I use a variable as ABC space 123? No. Whenever you define variables, you cannot use space. Can I use a variable name which starts from a digit? No. 22 BAC cannot be a variable name. BAC 22 can be a variable name, but my variable name cannot start with 2. So in all three, on all these four examples, the valid identifier is only QWERT, which I can use as a variable name. So if I use is identifier with S1, S2, S3, and S4, if you look at the output, only S1 gives result as true. Rest all S2, S3, and S4 will give the result as false. So if you want to check whether your string value is a correct identifier or not, you can use isIdentifier. This is how you can use isAlnum, isAlpha, isDecimal, isDigit, isIdentifier, and isNumeric functions in Python.